I think I have to thank God for sparing my life, the life of my wife, and the life of the wife of the senator representing Olu Senatorial Zonoble Rochas of Rochas, and more especially the life of the church members who were at the church when the incident happened. Again, I want to commend the IG so far for the professionalism IG has shown on this matter. I think I have confidence in the IG for what he has done so far. Because what happened on 26 was a sacrilege, and it was desecration of the altar of God. The men that came to arrest me, I was not invited, no prior notice, no invitation. I lost my mom. I buried my mom on the 22nd, and on 26th, I was in the church to do the outing service of my mom. Face mask security men entered the church and started shooting, and said that they've been directed to arrest me. And these men are not men from the police command, the way I saw them. They are from government house. I saw many of them, and even my security orderlies recognized some of them that worked in government house. And they said that these men are from government house. They started shooting and said, if I don't move, they are going to kill me. They started beating me up, tore my clothes, pushed me like a criminal, a common criminal. Threw me inside the car. I was asking them what happened, what have I done? They sped off with me, came to a particular place in Ijaba, pushed me out, cocked their guns, said I should come down. They threw me inside another waiting van, and then we moved down to Owerri. The remaining three vehicles drove inside Gome House, and one of the vehicles with four masked operatives without any sign that they are policemen, just one time, and they drove me all the way to Enugu. On the way, they were calling one Shaba, and the Shaba was calling them, giving them instruction on what to do. Shaba was always calling them, giving them instruction, asking them where they are, because I speak Hausa and I can hear them very well. They were speaking Hausa, their languages. And we got to a particular point. They asked me that I should pull my clothes. And they pulled my clothes, handcuffed me like a common criminal, and took my picture, and I asked them, why are you handcuffing me? Am I a criminal? What have I done? They told me that their Oga in Owerri asked them to send the pictures of me on handcuff so that they can send it to social media. That is the picture that is going viral on social media. And it was the same Shaba, who is the CSO to Governor Hope Uzodinma, that directed them to handcuff me like a common criminal and send the social media and send those pictures to the social media. I don't know why this should happen. I don't know why this should happen in Imo State. I was treated like a criminal. I was humiliated, even burying my mom. I was treated as if I'm an ordinary criminal on the road. I was beaten up. My clothes was torn. And when we got to Enugu, a private jet was waiting. Who paid for the private jet that took me to Abuja? It was not police jet. A private jet was at Enugu waiting for me. They drove me all. It would be like a criminal, a singlet. I was brought out with a handcuff, and they threw me inside the plane. And the plane was paid for somebody. Who paid for the plane? I'm happy that the IG has come into this, and the IG is doing a wonderful job now. The IG is being professional. I'm happy, and I want to thank the IG for what he has done so far. It's absolutely madness. This should not happen to Nigerians. If this what is the fate of Nigerians? You saw how they were shooting. They were shooting inside the altar, inside the church. They shot and scattered the church. If I should be arrested, the security in government house does not have right to arrest me. The people that have right is the police command. And if I should be arrested and picked up, I should be written. There should be a letter inviting me. And I will come and explain what, or if there is any allegation against me, I should be invited. I was never invited. There was no letter. There was no call. I was just picked up like a common criminal by security operatives from government house. I can't hide it. I can't hide it because I saw them, my orderlies, my security man that was attached to me for this, my mother's burial, saw all of them that they are from government house. What have I done? What have I done to warrant this humiliation? Putting me on a handcuff, taking my pictures. Who authorized the posting of those pictures to the social media? I know the IG, I know very well. who is a professional, cannot order people to put somebody's picture who is still under investigation on the social media with a handcuff. So who was the person that authorized them to do that? Because there is one Shaba who is the CSO in Government House who was giving them directive all this while they were humiliating me on the road to Enugu. Being a chief of staff in this state for 4 years, I was a commissioner for land for 3.5 years. I'm not a new person in this state. I have kept my record clean. I have not been into anything criminal or any supporting any militancy. I learned that they said that I was sending money and sending arms to the militants. And I asked them, who on my allegation, there is something I saw on the social media where they were circulating. The same people. If you watch that interview, on one interview that were interviewing somebody on a social media, asking him questions, you will hear the voice. That voice is them Shaba. Is it the duty of the CSO now to interview people and ask the person to say what they want and come back and say this person said Uchenwosu is giving them money? Where? There is no proof. You have not even invited me. There was no invitation. You came to church, discredited the house of God, and arrested me like a common criminal. Is that how to play politics? Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.